Hi, my name is Rich, WB5YBZ, and I just bought a Yaesu FT2980 FM transceiver for 2 meters. It's just strictly FM, doesn't have fusion or anything else, but I wanted to program this. Now, I looked online, and you push this button, then you push that button, then you push the frequency that you want with your hand mic in. And it just took forever. I got 3 simplex frequencies in there, and I got, oh man, this is just a nightmare. So I looked online, and I found RT Systems software. Now, they have them for different radios, but I wanted this particular one. And it's really simple. Now, it has a lot of other things that this software can do. I don't know about all those. You'll have to look into the help menu if you want to do something special with yours. But for me, this really got a lot of the repeaters in there very, very quick. So thanks for watching. Let's go over to the program.
So when you first start, and I've programmed 3 simplex frequencies in my computer, or in my radio by hand. So when you restart, you might want to receive those and get it from radio. Now, one thing I might add, make sure your radio USBs plugged into the computer and the microphones plugged into your radio before you turn it on and start cloning it and stuff like that. And then turn it off before you unplug the plug to the microphone. All right, get radio from data, or get data from radio. Insert the cable, press and hold the AN low while turning on the radio.
After you plug the cable into your microphone jack and also the USB into your computer, you hit your red start button or on button and this low button here at the same time, and it comes up as clone.
Verify the radio clone. Okay, we did that, and then hit set MW.
When you want to get data from your radio going to your program, make sure it says clone, and then press the megahertz button, and then it says it's starting to transmit the information on there.
There we go. Now it's getting the data that I have programmed by hand in here. There it is. Now if you notice, my priority channel is 5.2. That's where I'd like to. Because I like simplex. But I want some Oklahoma City repeaters in here, so I don't want to do it by hand. But how do I go about doing this? Well, first of all, you go to File, External Data, go to Repeater Book Search. You type your location. I'm going to just say 75 miles, and this is only just 2 meter for this particular radio. So we just hit OK. And if you notice, this is the Repeater Book Search, what's come up. This is my first 3 channels that I have programmed in here. In the yellow and the green is the research results. Now, I believe it goes by frequency here on the left. And look, Oklahoma City's here, here, here. I'm in Oklahoma City, here, down here, and I want, well, rats, I'd like to get them all together. So all you have to do is click the city. And as you can see, Oklahoma City is right here. Now, one of the things, if you notice, some of these are Echolink, D-Star, Fusion. I don't want Fusion. I don't want D-Star because my radio is a simple radio. See where it says select bands down here on the bottom? What we do is we click off D-Star, click off Fusion, and there we have it. We don't have those anymore. So that's very handy. Now I want to copy these things for Oklahoma City. So I go left click, and I come down this one. And now I'm going to hit the control or my shift key. My shift key and left click this one. All right. Then I'm going to hit right click and I'm going to hit copy. It should copy all those that I have highlighted. And I'll go back to my software, which is right here. I was looking for it for a second. And you have to left click this one. And when you see this little gap here, a little slot that's sort of highlighted, then you right click and hit paste. If you don't have that clicked, it's not going to paste it. There you have the different types of names. It'll show up on your screen as names. For example, this does not have a name. And therefore, I know it's going to be 146.52. It'll show up 5.52. There's a couple here that I know what they are, so I'm going to click those. And it'll just show me the frequency. And I'd like to know if all these are good or not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up Google. And I'm going to say ham repeaters. Well, I had typed in Oklahoma earlier, so Oklahoma Amateur Radio. This is repeaterbook.com, so I'm just going to click this. There it says Oklahoma repeaters. Again, it's going by the frequency, and it goes up. If you look at the cities, it's going. So I hit location. And that brings all the list of cities up here. Why I went to this repeater site is when I go to Oklahoma, see these little red X's? If you scroll up the top, it says off the air. So either they're not working anymore or there's something wrong with them. But since I don't know anything about this, I think I'll just start checking all the ones and deleting them. For example, this 230 KWFAA. I'll just delete that. This one here. And you just right click it and delete this channel. And the others move up, which is sort of nice. Now I'm going to delete some more because if you look at this list, I have some more here, 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 and here that are not working at this time, but I'm not going to put them in here. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and delete these others, but I'm going to put you on hold, so to speak. What I have done is I've deleted some of the names on the here because I know the frequencies. And if you don't want, let's say, if you don't want that name, so you could just type in, I think it's six letters, and you just say Simplex. Well, it doesn't give you an X. Five letters. No, six letters. Okay, it doesn't give you seven. All right. Now, what is sort of neat, if you're going on vacation, and let's say you're going to Dallas, and you've put in your Dallas stations, and then the next week you're going, or next day you're going to Phoenix, and the next day you're going to San Francisco, well, you probably want to keep, whoops, We have what they call banks. And you go, let's say you're going to Dallas, Phoenix, San Francisco, and Los Angeles. So these first three, I want to keep them in all three banks. But the Dallas, I want to put these two in for the Dallas. The Phoenix, I want to put these two in on this bank. For San Francisco, I want to put these two in. And for Los Angeles, I'm going to put these three in. So you can, with your microphone, hit the star button to go to a different bank, and which makes it pretty nice. I'm sure you would want to put more repeaters in here, but it's sort of nice that you don't have to figure out where in the world is it. You can just change it, put it to that particular bank designated. Well, it's sort of neat. You have eight banks that you can put your frequencies in, which could be different cities, different states if you want, whatever. And you could just have it per state if you wanted to, if you're going a long ways or whatever. Might be sort of easy for you to do something like that. All right, now what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to send this to our radio. We've got these programmed in. I have some of them de-checked because I know what they are. And, oh, by the way, you can put, let's see, where is it? You can put your power on different, for an example, you can click this on, that would be 5 watts, 10, 30, and 80 watts. So it's you can change your wattage here, especially if you're close to a repeater. You probably don't need that much power. So let's put it to the, send it to the radio. And it says, insert the cable, da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da-da-da. And then it says, press the MWD/MR. And then I push it, and then I hit OK. And it's transferring to the radio. And there it is. It's all programmed in the radio. When you want to send data, you have to hit your MWD/MR. Let's look at the radio now. All right, we're going to see how we did. We programmed, of course, by hand the 146.52 and the 55 and the 980. But here's where our starting on memory 3 is where we will check. And right there's one repeater. And I just left it checked for the ID. This one, I didn't want the W5MEL, I believe. I did not want it listed. I just wanted the frequency so I knew which one it was. And also with this one. And then, of course, here's a different one. And it looks like all the repeaters have, are off. And it looks like all the repeaters have been programmed into the Yaesu FT2980. Different settings here. You can adjust your, for example, your microphone gain. I have it on 5, but you can go higher if you want. Different things here that you want to maybe look at. One of the things you might do is look at your help, getting started, and you can just read various things about what everything does. A little bit more complex. It tells you a little bit, identifying a lot more than what I have given you here. So hopefully that will help you. Another thing is, once you have this, you can save it. Save as. And you can name it your program or whatever.